Hello everyone, I needed to make this video because I needed to share something that's been bothering me for quite a long time. Every time I sit down and think about it, the thing really baffles me because I look around and I feel like we're sitting on a ticking time bomb and nobody realizes the fact that we're sitting on a ticking time bomb. Nobody actually realizes the fact that we have a problem and something needs to be done fast. In schools now, secondary schools to be precise, the external exams are written both WAEC and NECO. Most schools, I don't want to give a figure, but I can tell you comfortably that most schools help students. That means they cheat through the whole exams. Even if they do not wish to cheat through the exams, these WAEC and NECO questions are available on different sites. All you need to do is just pay recharge card or make a transfer, and then just a couple of hours to the exam, the real thing is actually being released on the internet. So these kids download it, they read about it beforehand, and they enter the exam hall already knowing what it is that they are going to be writing on. Secondly, you now have kids that are writing exams from SS2, and people are very comfortable with it. They don't feel that it's an issue. They don't realize that, okay, writing exams in SS2, how can a child, you come and be celebrating an average student, some even failing, some have repeated SS2, repeated SS1 before, and then you're encouraging them to write in a miracle center, so to speak, exams, and they come out with their A's. And you don't even ask any questions. You don't actually talk, have one-on-one with them to know that, yes, this thing is actually theirs or it's right or something like that. You're okay with it. How can a child that is supposed to have covered 3 years worth of a curriculum write an exam when they have covered only a year and a half worth of curriculum, and then they come out with an A and you don't question it, you're just celebrating? Now, that means that the results are being bought in the secondary school, then admissions are being bought, because admission in schools is now about who you know. And then private schools just take anyone anyhow, because that's private universities. They're just desperate for them to have students, so they just take anyone anyhow, and then they're okay with it. Nobody complains, nobody asks, nothing. There are quack universities across the borders. I heard that in some countries, I'm not going to name African countries very close to us, you can go and actually come back with a degree in 6 months. Ask around, there are people that are going to tell you, I'm not making this up, it's true. I've actually done my research and it's actually 100% true. 6 months you come back with your BSc. So then we're saying that you can buy your result, you can buy your way into the university and through the university, right? So I heard that there are even some private schools in Abuja, private universities, that they just push students. There's nothing like even carry over or anything, because they're just like, you know, they just want to collect money and then just have enough students for them to stay afloat. Then we have results being bought, we have the admission, we have the whole results still again being bought in the university now. You come out, they graduate, and then jobs. They buy jobs still again, yet again, jobs are being bought. You pay this person, pay that person, and then just imagine, I want a juicy job. I hear even in millions you have to pay for a juicy job. So you pay for a juicy job, and I just want you to think about something. If I know that my father has paid, let's say, 1.2, 3 million, 4 million, whatever it is, for me to get a juicy job, there's absolutely no way that I'm going to feel like I need to work to keep my job. I mean, I heard this boss once saying that, you see these young kids, spoiled rich kids, with their legs on the table, pressing on their phone, going through stuff, and not working. And you can't go and talk to them and tell them to work, because you know that they know that they got their jobs from that oga at the top. And that oga that is up there has already eaten his money and he doesn't care. He's hardly even around. He's traveling all over the country, all over the world. He doesn't really care. So how then can the system actually work? We have this kind of people in ministries. Most ministries are empty. People just want to collect money. We have these big jobs where you have these poor rich kids that are collecting so much money, driving big cars, and the job is not actually being done. No proper training is being carried out on these people. There's no proper training whatsoever. You just have this big job and then they're just like thrown into the deep end. And then what? These same people are going to give birth to kids that they're going to do the same thing for. So like, it's a vicious cycle. And then it's scary because nothing is being done. Like, the country is already in a bad shape,
And it's like it's getting worse. And we keep blaming the government, but excuse me, we have a whole lot to do with the whole rot that we're sitting in now. And it's a serious thing, it's a serious issue. And if we do not stand up and do something about it, then we have a problem. When I was younger, when these exams were coming closer, my mom had, as you come back from school, you have private lessons that you're going for. We had a lesson teacher that was there. She didn't hear anything. Go study. There was nothing like, I'm going now, I'm going here, I'm going, go study. And if I even came home, I was scared to report to my mom and tell her that maybe I ran into trouble with a teacher or something like that. Because my mom, nowadays, parents are like, the first thing they want to do is, what did the teacher do? They don't even ask, what did you do? Because it's always the fact that the teacher is wrong. You're threatening the school. You just want to buy results. You just want kids to be pushed, pushed, pushed. Before it was class 6, that was an extinction. Kids from class 5 were writing exams. Now, do you know that kids from GSS 2 are writing their junior NECO, their BECE exams from GSS 2? Their schools are allowed that. Now, from SS 2, you have kids that are writing exams. I just don't understand this. Why is there no law in place to stop this? This is a problem. You have 13, 14-year-olds that are actually in the university, and they can't cope with the pressure. They're smoking, they're taking drugs. Look at it, especially in the north, there's been so much that has been said about the drug abuse, and there's nothing. You just have big seminars, you have people coming and making big noise on the internet, and then that's it. Nothing more is being done. Look, we're sitting on a ticking time bomb. Please save this video of mine, because a couple of years you're going to come back and you're going to realize that we have a big problem. And when we had the chance to correct this, we didn't do anything. We sat down and folded our hands and were very, very okay with it. I really hope that people are going to stand up and talk about this thing, talk against it. I mean, some schools, the truth is, I don't really blame them for helping their students in the exam hall, because they don't have the facilities to teach the kids. And then these kids have this sense of entitlement. They feel like whatever happens, I just have to pass. Whatever happens, my parents are going to buy results for me. So it's terrible. It's terrible. We really need to stand up and do something about it.